Well,
okay. Hey. Did not.
Okay. Curse of Corona. Multiplayer. Commanders only.
Right. Yeah. What do we got? We got Yennett going up against Chatterfang.
Going up against Sheoldred.
Are you using your squirrels?
And I'm using, yeah, the squirrels, Chatterfang.
Squirrels and horrible black bullshit. And odd goings on.
And the odds goings on.
Okay, right. Rules for Curse of Corona. Corona's got her deck sitting out here. On your turn, you may choose to pray to Corona once or zero times.
Pray to Corona?
Yep, if you pray to Corona, you just, you take the top card of her deck and you play it. If,
Alright.
It's a permanent, it comes into play under your control. If it's cursed, it's attached to you. And it's full of totally good stuff that you actually want. For sure,
totally.
Diabolical.
Nice things. Nice things.
Nothing in there that's gonna ruin your day. And if you...
No, of course not.
Choose not to pray to Corona, your deck ticks up from 4, which is 0, to 1.
That's my roll.
If it gets to 3, Corona will come onto the battlefield under your control at the beginning of your end step, and which, according to her ability, she will then go to the next player
immediately.
And she likes to attack and
these G4s restart on 4.
Pumps a tribe. Yes. Yeah, 4 is your 0. Yeah, and that's all there is to. Oh, and it's got her own tracker. If nobody prays for 3 turns, she will also come out at the end of that turn.
Automatically.
So you don't for 3 turns in a row, or nobody does for 3 turns in a row. She will come out. If you pray, it resets your day and her day.
Alright, I'm excited. I'm excited. How about you guys? Woo!
Woo!
They're glossy like mine. Turn it out.
No, who gave them to me? If you didn't,
like it was me. Yeah, it must have been. It must have been Forrest.
Could have been.
Because it wasn't me. Oh, I wish I could take credit. Hey, this is like how it has been for other magic things, and I can't get it, so it's the other way around. I can't remember which of you gave me those planes all the time. All the time. Which of you did give me?
Forrest gave me his points.
Okay. Well, I rolled 24.
I rolled 21.
21?
Yep. 21? Turn them up.
21?
21.
Okay.
21.
Hey.
The exact same numbers as me and everything?
Oh, wow.
Cray cray.
We are alike in Corona.
I don't know if I want to be alike Corona. You know what I mean?
Okay, that's interesting.
That'll work. Alright, so multiplayer, I get to draw a card for going first. And then I will put down a woodland cemetery, and am I going to pray to Corona? No, I'm not going to pray to Corona. It's going to be your turn, Ashley.
Mm-hmm. You could get a mana rock. You could get a big freaking dragon.
If nobody prays to Corona, I'll get him on my turn.
I'll pray to that bitch. Wait, I don't. I want to pull it. How do I pull the card?
You just go for it. So you keep that on 4.
Yeah.
I do pray
to
it.
Reset to 4. Yeah. So take the top card of your deck and play it.
What is it? Ooh, a siege. Oh, invasion of Pyrulia. When it enters, I scry 3, then reveal the top card of my library. If it's a land or double face card, draw a card. And then I will choose someone to protect it, and then we can attack it.
Right, it works like the curse. It's yours to protect.
Right.
Oh, okay. That makes
sense. So whoever destroys it gets
yes.
the other side.
Whichever one of us destroys it, we get it.
That's kind of fun.
Goes with, a word transform. Anyway, sorry. Scry 3.
Alright, you could probably attack your own. Why wouldn't you be able to attack the
Well, you can't attack your own. It can only be attacked by creatures. It can't be just dealt direct. Some things deal damage to battles.
Huh. But if
someone plays a battle and puts it under your control,
you can't
get the thing from it. I don't think. Maybe you can destroy it with those.
Okay.
But
you're not allowed to attack it.
Well, no, you can't attack your own shape. You and others can attack it.
You and others can attack it. Okay.
And others. It's defeated, exile it, then cast to transform. The person protecting it can't attack it.
Well, just said
sure. What?
You and others.
Yeah.
Can't attack it.
Others. Not
you and others.
Yeah.
I'm gonna scry in this order.
Wait, when you play it normally,
right?
Then I reveal the top card in my library. It's a swamp.
Okay.
Revealed. If it's a land, yes. Or a double faced card, draw a card.
It was
that swamp. Cool. And it has 4. Thing going on here. 4.
Okay, someone could get whatever cool things on the back of that.
Okay.
We'll play.
Does it stay at 4/2? Mine?
Yeah.
4.
Oh. Right, you reset yours anytime you press. Okay, I'm gonna play the Black Dragon Gate. Enters tapped, it makes black, and when it enters, I choose a color other than black, which I am going to choose blue. And totally remember that. And it worked out okay for everyone. But I'm not gonna put a Corona. Your turn, Will. Need little colored stones for these lands. I guess I could use
You want some colored stones? Oh, I only have foggy or clear. You mean colored ones?
No.
You were just at the pet store. Don't they have the little glass pebbles for the...
They probably do.
That's clears and foggies and a special coin.
I don't know which one makes blue.
I'm gonna trade a Corona.
You want something blue? Colored
stone? Sorcery. Cultural exchange.
Okay.
Choose any number of creatures target player controls.
Nobody's got any creatures.
Choose the same number of creatures, those exchange those creatures, nothing happens.
No creatures.
There we go.
Perfect. I took the cyberpunk ones. Okay. Well, that was completely harmless.
There's others where that came from, too.
Okay, your turn, Ash.
Corona's no problem.
No problem at all.
That's what she wants you to think.
She's no big deal. Ash and I come out unscathed. No need to worry, guys. Just try her out. She's a good ride.
I don't know if she's going to smile on you the next time you drop from that deck. It's not about Corona like that.
Gonna have to discard. It looks like.
I think actually she drew an extra one off her.
Okay. Well, I can't play anything more than a land this turn, so.
Are you gonna pray to Corona?
She could give you a monorail.
Don't try to trick me. No.
Okay, yeah. Hers goes to one, you get a one. Great. I'm gonna play an Evolving Wilds. I am not gonna pray. And I'm gonna pass the turn to you, Will, and do my Evolving Wilds.
Corona.
Corona.
She's been pulling her punches.
I'm gonna tap three.
Right.
One, bring out the squirrel mom. It's a 2/2 that can get a +1/+1 for each of the squirrel on the battlefield.
Get at that battle, huh?
Yeah. And then I'm not gonna pray to Corona, and it's Ash's turn.
You're also not gonna pray to her?
That's correct.
What gives?
Because I feel like you.
Right, so if you don't pray to her, she will come out.
And Ryder will get her.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I mean, for my turn.
Well, we can put down this navigation orb. It's a pay two, tap it, sack it. Search for two basic land cards and or gate cards. Reveal those cards. Put one onto the battlefield tab and the other in my hand and shuffle. I think I will pray to her. Put her back to one or four? Put her to four.
I do to four. I don't know if it'd make more sense to, like, just stay at one. And when it gets to four...
Discard my motherfucking hand.
One with nothing.
That's harsh.
That's real harsh. Corona.
Thanks, Corona.
So fuck her.
That's it. That's the whole card.
Yeah.
When nothing remains, everything is equally possible.
Oh, that sucks.
That's where I'm at in life, man. When nothing remains, everything is equally possible. It's actually not... It's not super sad.
No.
Wait, it's like that thing we were talking about. If it's all right, then what's left?
What's left? All right.
What is left if it's all right?
Nothing.
Nice.
Nothing's left.
Nothing's
if
left.
It's all right.
If it's all right.
But it's all right. It's all right. You
don't care about. Really need a bunch of squirrels beating me up with their corona powers, so I am gonna pray. Second chance!
Oh, how nice for you.
During my upkeep, if I have 5 life or less, sacrifice second chance and take an extra turn after this one.
Well, you can just
wow.
Put that off in your playmat's hair.
Yeah.
The outer cosmos just hovering around in case you might ever need it someday.
Mm-hmm. Wow,
nice.
That's pretty lucky, Ryder.
Wow.
And then I'm going to play another 3-cost blue enchantment, The Eyes Everywhere. At the beginning of my upkeep, I will scry one, and I can pay 6 to exchange control of eyes everywhere and target non-land permanent.
Wow.
And neither of you have blue, so yes. It'll be permanent. But you'll get to scry.
Jeez.
But I need 6 to do it, which is not close. And that's your turn one.
Okay.
Chimney drops.
I think that one with nothing might be the worst one to get in there. At least in the beginning. A lot of them are really can be really harsh in the beginning. Why is that place?
Oh, what a terrible place it was. I see that now.
What?
I didn't think it was a terrible place to put the burritos.
This is weird. It's kind of it's by the bubble.
Could not have perched. The right etiquette around that bone today. Trying to be respectful of your bone.
I'm gonna tap 3. Bring out Chatterfang. And I don't feel the need to pray to Corona. Squirrel.
What's his static ability? Oh right, if you make tokens, you make extra squirrel tokens.
Yes. I make that many squirrel tokens as well. Or if I sacrifice X squirrel, right. Target creature gets plus X minus X until end of turn. This 3/3 is going to attack.
There's the battle. Can't quite do it in one go. Maybe next time we can do it in one go.
I'll attack, yeah, the battle.
Cool.
The siege. For 3.
Sweet, thanks, man. Fuck yeah.
I mean, probably get some big giant creature out of it. It's probably not great for us if it gets that, but what are we gonna do about it?
Right.
Well, it sucks that I can't, like, attack it. I'd have to come at it some other
but,
way.
But, I mean, she gets it?
No, you get
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I get it. If yeah. I control it, right.
Or if I swoop in there and somehow do
yeah,
one damage
how can
to a
you though?
There's some of those, like, new cards
yeah,
that
like, you don't have
deal
that
direct
deck.
Damage to...
No way, no how. Alright, Ashley, it's going to be your turn.
Double D, direct damage dealt. Oh, that's triple D's.
Triple D's, whoa.
Double damage dealt?
Triple damage dealt.
Quiffle?
Quiffle.
No such thing. Go over here, Edie. Alright, I have no hand. It feels weird. Feels weird to not have a hand.
That looks weird. Yeah.
Sheoldry.
Oh man.
For 4.
Now we got Sheoldred out here.
Death Touch 4/5. Whenever I card, draw a card, I gain 2 life. Whenever an opponent draws a card, they lose 2 life. No big deal.
Big deal.
I'll go ahead and not pray to her. If I looks like she's at 0. Seems
yeah.
Great.
Okay. Well, she should be at 1.
Okay.
No, she's at 2.
Wait, which is it? Those are all different numbers.
Well, right. If you don't pray, then she's at 2.
Ah, yeah. That. That is true.
Okay. If I don't pray, then she will come out.
I'm totally fine with it, right?
How are you now?
Yeah. No big deal to me.
Glad you're so casual.
I lose 2 life for Sheoldred.
Yeah.
Might want to try and.
Nope.
Me
did you draw a card?
Yes.
Did you lose 2 life?
Yes.
Oh no, I. That's right. She just came out here. It's the first time.
Right.
I'll remind people of the triggers that I do.
Okay. I'm going to play this Plains, and then gonna pray. Corona,
you don't, need
don't
to
do me wrong. Ooh, I'm so tired.
Oh no!
Curse of Exhaustion, and change a player can't cast more than one spell each turn.
Oh, here, stamina.
One spell per turn, which is kind of lame.
That's pretty bad.
One of those white curses?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Alright, well, I'm gonna play the Twilight Prophet.
My curse is your Nicole Bullets
spell. She's a 2/4 with flying and ascend. If I get the city's blessing at the beginning of my upkeep, I'll reveal the top card of my library. And each opponent will lose X life, and I'll gain X life, where X is that card's mana cost. But I need to control things.
Eight permanents.
Corona's things are not my things. So
oh, they don't count.
Those don't count.
Right.
Yeah. So I only have six, and that was a fucking stupid curse, and it's your turn, Will. Just let Corona come out. Let the squirrel mayhem commence.
Black. Why are you devil's advocating those squirrels?
Fuck. This curse of exhaustion, like, ruined shit in my deck a little bit.
Right?
It's my commander lets me cast spells at the top of my library for free. So I can only do that if I don't do something else.
Is there any disenchant in there?
There is probably... There should be something in here that'll disenchant. There are some disenchant in Corona's deck.
Nice.
I'm gonna tap two forests and three others
so
to awaken
to break
the warts. I'm going to create 3/1/1 green forest dryad land creature tokens, and then I'm going to create 3/1/1 green squirrel creature tokens.
No big deal.
Squirrels are getting crazy.
Well, did you take 2 life for drawing your card? I know you didn't.
Take 2 life for drawing that card. Thanks for the reminder.
No, it's my responsibility.
Yeah, it kind of is, because I'm going
to
totally
you.
Forget.
It might not happen if I don't confirm.
And there are 3 of these guys. Yeah. Just 3. Okay. This guy should not attack anymore. And then I'm going to attack with both of these guys, the siege.
You want to make the siege happen for me?
For me.
Whoever destroys it gets it?
Yes.
Huh. Well, you earned it. You did everything to
Woo.
It.
What a lucky hit.
And you just don't want to block?
Oh, right.
It was bound to happen.
1, 2, 3, 4 squirrels out there. He gets +4/+4, so he's a 6/6.
I mean, yeah. It's true. I suppose I could block that 6.
Wouldn't you just block his commander, though? Wouldn't you just kill it?
I don't know why I attacked with my commander.
Yeah, sure. But it just puts a couple attacks on it. He could just afford it next turn. It wouldn't. I think it would be more important. Is this a 6/6?
Yeah.
It seems better to block. But I do have full 40 life.
But I'm not attacking you, I'm attacking the siege.
True. Can I block for a
yes.
siege?
Yeah.
I'm protecting it.
Yeah. It's kind of like I'm having a planeswalker.
Right.
Well, you're going to get it either way.
Yeah.
But sure, I'll block and kill your fucking commander.
I shouldn't have attacked
you. Yeah, do something. He's got way too much shit over there. He's going to be goddamn murderous.
Don't worry. I made this deck more recently.
I have a feeling.
I think this is one of them.
It's gonna get.
Probably has more kill spells.
With those squirrels.
Board wipes. It's black.
Okay, I got beastie.
I got damnation.
Trample ward, 2 beasts. Other transform permanents you control have trample ward 3. I don't have any transform permanents. Interesting, huh? Okay. I'm going to pray to Corona.
Thought for sure you'd let her out.
Curse of Inertia. Enchanted player. Whenever enchanted player attacks, whenever a player attacks enchanted player with one or more creatures, that attacking player may tap or untap target permanent of his or her choice. Weak.
Okay. Nice.
Interesting.
And Ryan, do you remember what Corona's ability does?
Oh, it gives plus to all your creatures that share your creature type?
Yeah, I think it's like +3/+3. It's all your creatures that share your type.
Yeah, but I don't want you guys to have her. I want to have her.
Right. You would have had to take a little bit of a beating, but...
Yeah, I'm trying to time it.
It's my turn?
Yep, that'll make it your turn.
Gonna gain...
I think we're gonna try to...
Two lives. When I draw this card. 40... to 42. Where am I even touching this one? Why are you in here? You guys both have 38 life? I think... I think I would like to do the navigation orb. I'm going to search my library for up to 2 basic land cards and or gate cards. Reveal those cards. Put one onto the battlefield tapped and the other in my hand and shuffle. In my hand and... I know there's a couple more right next to each other. We're on the battlefield. Tippity tapped.
How did Bagel eat all that hay all day? Where does it all go?
He's a hay disposal.
He's a munchy monster.
Munchy monster. Part of the monster madness.
Gatsuks. So glossy.
Are you attacking anybody?
He's a plenty shuffle, I'm sure. Oh, you're not even gonna. Do you want to shut? Do you want to cut it?
Okay. That is my cut.
Can I actually cut it? I'll pray to her. I'm gonna pray to her.
No. Then don't change it.
I'm not gonna change it. I'm gonna see what happens. Corona, what you got for me? Breaking point. C'est la vie. Destroy all creatures unless a player has breaking point. Deal 6 damage to him or her.
I'm fine with destroy all creatures.
Creatures destroyed this way can't be regenerated.
So
I'm fine with that. That sounds great, actually. Yeah. I can deal with these squirrels.
Take 6 damage here. Let all your shit die.
Yeah.
I'm taking 6 damage.
Oh, come on, man. Sweet, sweet breaking point. All right, it has resolved. Okay.
All you guys' stuff is destroyed. Oh, unless somebody...
No, it isn't. Just for that little comment, I want to attack you so hard, but I should save it to block. But I just really want to attack you. It's 40. Attacking William!
Alright, what do you want to tap?
4/5. Oh, I would like to untap my own. Right?
Mm-hmm.
That makes sense. Okay. So 4/5 death touch.
Alright, now block it with a squirrel.
A 1/1 squirrel?
Mm-hmm.
Ceases to exist. There you go. Ryder's turn.
Okay.
Man, veggie burritos are worth it just for like getting freaking lettuce and rice and beans and guacamole and pico, de gallo for sure. All the best things. Instead of making it like a jumbo, to get some lettuce and some guacamole.
Okay. I guess we are going to. What are we about to do? I can only play one spell per turn. So that's freaking lame. Oh, man. From now on, I'm going to remember that I have my eyes everywhere. Alright.
Are you supposed to remind Ryder something?
Did you lose your life for drawing your card, Ryder? Oh yeah, that's my responsibility to remind everyone of my triggers. Shit. Okay, thanks, Will. I'm going to be on top of telling you guys, if you don't. Unless you do, and I won't.
Well, I guess I'm going to pray to Corona. See what she's got for me. A cosmic horror!
No!
Oh, I'm so close to being able to do it. Play that isolated watchtower. I'm not going to be able to keep it. That's 7-7 with first strike. During my upkeep, I got to pay 3/3 black or destroy cosmic horror. Mm-hmm. And if it's destroyed this way, it deals 7 damage to you. Mm-hmm. So it's going to be angry with my lack of devotion to black here.
Yeah.
So I can only make 2 black.
Hopefully you draw one.
Well, I won't be able to play it before my upkeep.
Oh, no, yeah.
Hold on a moment, I guess. Alright. I play Yennett, the Cryptic Sovereign. 1, 2. White, black, and blue. 2 others. 3/5. Flying, vigilance, menace. When she attacks, look at the top card of my library, and if it's odd, I may cast it.
Mm-hmm.
It's casting cost. Converted mana cost. Mana value now. That's the eternal. I don't think I've seen anybody actually be able to keep the cosmic horror around yet. You could do it. You got all that black and not a lot of stuff to spend your mana on.
Mm. Yeah.
I also just don't have 6. Sorry.
I will.
Yes, Ashley, I will lose my 2 life.
I don't have to tell you if I do see you do it.
My sister.
Good job, Will. Good job. You lost your 2 life. It's a good little test, though. It's like, I'm not losing life unless you tell me to. Pay attention to triggers test.
I'm gonna pay 4. Bring out Liege of the Hollows.
Ooh.
Liege of the Hollows is a 3/4 spirit. If Liege of the Hollows is put into any graveyard from play, each player may pay any amount of mana to put that number of squirrel tokens under his or her control. Treat those squirrels as 1/1 green creatures.
Treat them right.
Squirrels, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. That's actually kind of interesting. Corona.
And then I'm going to tap all the forest dryads for forests and these 2 for a total of 5 to bring out Triumph of the Hordes. Sorcery. No, sorry. Not that card. The Deranged Hermit.
The Deranged Hermit, of course. That's all I ever heard.
Deranged Hermit is a 1/1 with Echo. During the upkeep after this permanent, underpay its casting cost or sacrifice it. Okay. Deranged Hermit comes into play, put 4 squirrel creature tokens into play, treat those squirrels as 1/1 green creatures.
8 squirrels,
I don't got my commander.
Commander.
Uh-uh.
Nice.
So put four more squirrel creature tokens out, and all squirrels get +1/+1.
All squirrels get +1/+1. Not counters, so only while it's out.
Yes.
It's a buff. Okay, it's my turn.
All right, so
oh,
I'm
are you praying? Are you doing stuff? Yes.
I remind you about the anchor.
Got a total of 5 squirrels out.
You only had 1 squirrel before?
2 squirrels. So I got a total of 6 squirrels out.
Wow.
Eventually, these guys are going to represent my
attack.
Okay, and then I'm going to attack. Am I going to attack?
So that guy's what, like an 88 now?
Oh, Jesus Christ, how big is he?
You could have done it with a 6.
6 plus.
6 on him.
Right.
Okay, yeah, right. I think that's 6 on him. Yep. He's going to attack.
But he's like a 9/9 because of that.
Right.
Guy
but
other squirrels get +1/+1.
Got my commander. Where? 3/5, a 2/4, and a 7/7 with first strike.
I have a 4/5 with death touch. That's all I have. I swear.
Come at me, bro.
I swear.
It's got death touch. It's so annoying.
Oh, who cares? Wow, how did
I'm
you...
gonna attack Ashley with a 9/9.
Great. I'll totally block and kill it.
Okay.
What the fuck? Why didn't you attack?
Because you're going to get dealt 7 damage.
Yeah, I don't want to get dealt
7 damage. I know you don't.
Did you pray?
I did not pray and I'm not going to, so it's your turn.
You only on 1?
Yeah, because I prayed to Corona last time and got a horrible curse. So fuck that bitch.
Horrible curse.
That was just the last turn. Yeah.
Horrible.
It was horrible.
I'd rather have that than fucking my exhaustion.
Yeah.
All right,
it's not
so
good for my deck at all.
We're at 36 and 30. Are you guys' lives right now?
Mm-hmm.
Killer. Killer. She's been out once. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is the tax to bring her on back now. And I will pray. Yeah, so... She goes to 2 and I go to 1. Is that what's going on here? What I do?
Mm-hmm.
Great.
Well, if you're praying, she goes to 4, you go to 4.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Someday I'll understand.
Praying resets.
Ooh,
it.
Cool
it counts
art.
If you don't.
Look at this cool art. Mana Clash.
Oh, right. Gonna do
1995. Not even a range. Why? Cool. You and target opponent each flip a coin. Mana Clash deals 1 damage to any player whose coin comes up tails. I prefer tails. Repeat this process until both players' coins come up heads at the same time. All right, well, I have a coin. I have 1 coin, but...
I got a coin.
Okay.
There's...
Where'd that silver sack go that I plopped on this table?
There's a couple of coins here.
No, I want my special.
Special coin.
Waited.
You
I'm
waited coin, huh?
No, wait. I mean, it
should
is.
Should I flip my tetradrachm?
It does have a nice heft to it. Yeah, you got a cool coin? Juice.
Yeah, I'm not flipping my.
These
my
are common
ancient,
quarters!
I'm not flipping my ancient tetradrachm.
Oh, no. Oh, that. No.
I don't think I have any other cool coins.
You better not.
I guess I have the I Ching.
Look, it's worth a whole dollar.
Mmm. Well, who are you going up against? Will, with all the stuff in third
you,
life?
Your hands are free.
36, all right.
Okay, hoping for heads, hoping to flip heads
I'm
at the
let
same
just
time.
Land on the, I guess you're hoping for heads and that I get tails.
No, we both want to come up heads at the same time. Oh, yeah, you're
no,
right.
I
want
to get heads and you to get tails.
I want to get heads and you to get tails.
I got heads.
I got tails.
Ha! 1 damage!
All right, we just got to keep doing this.
Yep.
Are we leaving it on the table, or are we trying to catch it and then flip it over?
I'm trying to just leave it on the table.
Okay.
God. I got heads.
Oh,
okay.
We're done.
Well.
All right, mana clash. Sure looks cool, though.
Yeah.
Alrighty, gonna attack Willis. It's my death touch 4/5. I'm gonna choose to untap my own.
Unbroken squirrel.
Deja vu. Know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
One less squirrel. Ready's turn.
Okay.
Wow. I took one damage. I don't think of all the ways that could have gone. That, I mean.
That's... Okay. Well, I can't pay the upkeep cost on Corona's cosmic horror. Your gift was too rich for me, Corona, so I will take 7 damage, going down to 29.
I like
that. Yep, that was a little painful.
She is the devil.
I'm gonna play this.
She's like, what's that lovely human gal who... That guy's lover who got stolen by the devil to be his own? Like...
Like the Sandman?
No. Like off of Dante's Inferno, but that cool, you know.
I don't know.
No.
Anybody got 7 lands?
6.
Castlevania was.
I think I actually have 6 as well.
Yeah, I have 6 lands. What of it?
Okay. Well, if you had 7, I could see things from my isolated watchtower.
Tempting.
Is
that what they're calling it these days?
Is that what the kids say, huh?
The isolated watchtower.
Oh,
that's where they do drugs.
No, I'm in a dick.
Whoa!
That's the isolated watchtower.
Yeah.
The isolated watchtower is what they call their dick these days?
No, I like the previous narrative you're going up with.
Yeah,
that's where they go to do the drugs. That's where they tag graffiti.
Yeah.
Like after bedtime.
Okay. Totally.
These days it'd be where kids go to sing their indie songs.
And apparently,
because the
dicks.
Reverb's nice. Literally, I saw a video of someone doing it. It's
supposed to lose to life. Stupid Sheoldred. So much dip talk made me forget what's going on.
I don't have that talk in the tit.
Talk in the tit, not the dick.
Back to that, are we?
Alright. I'm gonna cast this Brainstone.
Brainstone.
Yeah, and then I'm gonna
It's almost like it's almost Kingdom Deathy with all the faces facing different directions, being all trippy. With the light, you know, all the lanterns is all in them.
That's a cool little background there.
The faces of faces.
Right, I'm gonna use the Brainstone to do a brainstorm and draw 3 and put 2 from my hand on top of my library.
The Ambassador.
And I'm gonna put these 2 on top of my library. And then, will your 30, Ashley's at what? 41. It's a little awkward because I know you could just kill one of us at any time. I triumph with the hordes. Not both of us, though. But when I had that brainstorm. And I got the city's blessing, so Twilight Prophet's thing will happen now on my upkeep. Alright.
got too much life. Yeah. Yeah, alright. Actually, I'm attacking you for 5. Oh. I'm attacking you for 5 with flying.
The song is tripping me up.
I was daydreaming about sugar babies and sugar daddies and their dynamics. Because of the song. I'm you're attacking me. You're attacking me.
I'm attacking you.
With something flying that I will two, block four, if I can.
A flying 2/4 and a flying 3/5 with... right, but before you take that damage, Yennett's thing goes off. Reveal the top card of your library. That card's converted mana cost is odd. Look at it, 7. You may cast it without paying its mana cost.
Dun, dun, dun.
Otherwise, draw a card. 7. It's the debtor's knell. It's going to let me reanimate a creature from any graveyard
any.
At the beginning of my upkeep.
Every upkeep.
Damn it, and I didn't scry from my eyes everywhere.
I don't have any creatures. Ha.
Once.
Not a single fucking creature.
I thought for sure you were gonna have creatures.
None is a creature.
I got one creature, the squirrel.
Yeah, I don't have any creatures either. Man, I just figured Ashley discarded her whole hand.
None
I'm sure there's gonna be
none.
Stuff in there.
Got other things going on.
That's impossible.
Yeah, it absolutely is possible. 100 single cards in these decks. It's going to play different. We got Corona going on. Come on.
Shit.
You don't know what you're going to draw anyway.
All right. Well.
Thousands of games out of not one deck.
Still.
Each different than the next.
I'm tired of being exhausted. I can't play any other spells.
You're tired of being tired?
Yeah. Yeah, the little brain stuff.
Oh. I heard that somewhere.
Did you pray to Corona?
No, I
sick
didn't pray to Corona.
Sick.
Corona
seems
of
like the
tired.
Only thing that can help you right now. She's put you in this hole. She can dig you out.
I'm not that bad off.
you lose 2 life for when you drew a card?
Yes.
You did? Are you lying?
No, he did this turn. I saw.
You wouldn't.
Alright, Corona, what do we got? What do we
there
got?
You go.
What do we got? Buck nuds have a full pus.
Buck nuds have a full pus. Yeah, I already using my
D4 to make treasure and then the player to your
who
right.
Has another D4? Oh, I'll go get fossilized coral die.
Okay. That's a thing.
Fossilized coral D4 can go with Bucknard's ever
it's pretty
purse.
Sweet for you. Well, it gets you squirrels along with treasure.
Hey.
I know, right? It looks like Ryder's already
where's
using it.
The,
I'm already using it.
Where's the... Oh. I was afraid.
My turn?
Yeah.
All right, I've got to pay that echo effect.
Okay, the amethyst D4. The
if
amethyst D4.
I'm going to choose.
Oh, these are obsidian. You're using that. This time. Aha. Bucknard. Okay.
If I were to gain control of a curse, I'd be able to reattach it. Probably not.
If you get Lindy, Cheerful Tormentor. Whenever a curse enters the graveyard, instead return it to your battlefield. At the beginning of your upkeep, attach it to target player. Life for free. Just awesome.
So, how many infect can you? How much infect can you take before you die?
It's poison. If they get 10 poison counters.
10 poison counters, huh? Oh shoot! But I got a 10. Gotta do it.
What did you use the rest of your mana?
To do the echo on
the
deranged event.
Pump up the jams. Is it my turn? Did you pray to Corona? Did you lose 2 life when you drew a card?
I did not lose 2 life when I drew a card yet.
Just trying to keep us honest around here.
And now I did.
And then?
And then. For all your smack talk, Ashley.
impertinent.
Coming at you with. Well, I got a total of 5 squirrels.
Yeah, I killed one.
No, I did pray.
Again.
I'm going to attack you with 3 squirrels. And. a 4-4 with trample on ward 2. And...
So ward is just pay 2 colorless to be the target of spells or abilities?
Yes.
Okay.
Or just tack it on to whatever you're paying to target.
I think I will block the gargantua with my death touch. Okay. And I live, and you don't.
Right.
And then 4 gets rid of me. How many squirrels?
3 squirrels, three of them. And a 3-4 as well, so a total of 6.
Is this a pump for all squirrels?
This is the number of dryads there are.
Oh, sorry.
3 squirrels, isn't 3 squirrels 6 damage?
Yes, it is. They are 2-2s. That's
what we're trying
damage
to figure out.
And a 3-4, so that
9.
Is 9 total damage.
Right. 32 and 41.
Right. I liked having that battle in there.
That was nice.
Yeah.
Corona still hasn't come out.
Speaking of which, am I going to pray to... Ryder, would you just get Bucknard Snopes? So the chances of me getting something good are a little bit slimmer. Your turn, Ashley.
Untippity tappity. Draw a card, gain 2 lives.
Why can't y'all just let Corona out? I want Corona to be out.
Put a swamp. That makes 7 swamps now.
So, if I don't pay her 3 times, she comes out on my turn, going to the next person.
Yeah.
It's kind of not what I want either.
I'm gonna use this first to get some treasure.
Alright!
He's getting treasure.
Treasure.
Does that mean it goes to me?
Nope. Goes to the player to your right.
That's Ashley. Yes. And Ashley gave it to me.
If she uses it.
I'm gonna bring out the Well of Lost Dreams over here.
It's tapped right now.
Okay. The Well of Lost Dreams, an artifact. Whenever I gain life, I may pay X, where X is the less than or equal to the amount of life I gained. If you do, draw X cards. Which gains me more life. Which... Then I draw more cards? Like, where does that cut off? Maybe just the one time?
What?
Because it says, whenever you gain life. Not whenever you gain one or more life. So I was just wondering.
So it's the instance in
where
which
does
you
the
gain
loop
life
end?
So...
Then, if you do, draw X cards... Which causes me to gain life.
Yeah.
Which I was just
wondering. So it goes on. It goes on as long as you want it to go.
As long as you pay X.
Yeah.
Yeah.
As long as
okay
you keep paying for it.
Of course. Of course. Yes, of course. Of course. 28 and 27.
All right. What do you have?
34. Yes.
Bullshit,
and well, at least she's not doing anything else.
I'm gonna attack Willis again. Same shit. Well,
what?
Same shit. I'm gonna attack you with Sheoldred. Choose myself to untap. Choo choo. Because you still curse.
And I'm gonna block with a squirrel.
Lose one more squirrel.
Yeah.
Okay.
Squirrel.
And then
I'll choose him because he looks fat and lazy.
Not a squirrel that's already tapped, huh?
Yeah.
Can't block with a tapped squirrel.
Oh yeah, that doesn't make sense.
Yeah, what are you talking
about? I was thinking
about?
It was like sacrifice or something. Yeah, and then I'm totally gonna pray to her. See what happens.
Why do y'all want to pray to Corona Squirrel?
Where am I? Ooh, Plague Reaver.
Plague Reaver.
It's a black beast. How perfect for me. 6/5. At the beginning of my end step, which it's about to be, sack each other creature you control. Well, that kind of sucks. Discard 2 cards. I only have 1. Sacrifice Plague Reaver. Oh, choose target opponent. Return Plague Reaver to the battlefield under that player's control at the beginning of their next upkeep. So pass this thing around. It's like a mini shield.
Yeah.
Causing everyone to fucking sacrifice each other player you control. Oh, that's what that meant. Okay.
Right, so you can use its ability to discard 2 cards and sack it.
I don't have 2 cards to sack
it. You can't do it.
And it's the beginning of my end step.
Return player to battlefield. Player's control at the beginning of their next upkeep.
Wow.
So Rot just killed your Sheoldred.
And I already attacked. And it has some consequences.
That
anyway.
End step you have to give to somebody else?
No.
No, I would have to discard two cards to give it to someone else, exile it, return to battlefield under a different. But okay. I only have
right.
one card.
You can avoid its plague thing by
right.
discarding two cards and sacrificing it.
Okay.
It'll come back under somebody else's control. Okay.
My instinct.
So. Okay, and so
what
Ashley, you have no you still have no creatures in your graveyard because that was your commander, right?
Yeah.
Well,
I got squirrel mob.
Give me that squirrel mob.
No creatures.
So I'm a flat squirrel mob. All right.
My squirrels.
Can I see your graveyard,
Ashley? Sure.
Sure,
you
can. Take a gander. Have a peek. Have a sniff?
Or sniff my cards?
okay.
That was the reaction
that
I was looking for.
This guy.
I didn't scry.
I can, Ryder.
Did you lose your life for drawing a card?
You don't have shield yet.
Yeah, why would you make us do this?
Because now I'm used to saying it a little
bit. Okay. This one's going to make blue and black, so it's just like the other one.
So, those are all the blue sources?
Yes. Bum, 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 bum.
Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum.
Okay, I'm gonna play this crystal ball.
That's going in Crystal Beard deck.
And then I'm gonna use this crystal ball. And one and tap it to scry too.
My Elminster deck.
We'll do that. Aunt Zen. Fuck, I forgot to do my Twilight Prophet as well.
What's going on over there?
Just.
I'm
not,
sorry, I'm not ridering you properly.
The,
we need to remind him of his triggers as well.
Yeah.
If
what's
he forgets.
Going on?
He would do the same for us.
This is gonna be hopefully this is gonna remind me. Do all the things on your upkeep.
Did you do hers?
Do
no.
All the things
oh,
on your...
you fucked up, right?
I did. Totally fucked up.
Well,
how'd you
still within your turn, you know you...
I did the debtor's knell on
the
my upkeep, but that was
okay,
it.
That was the
no, we're
thing.
Partially to blame. We should have reminded you of your own shit. It was
that's
also
why you
our
the quarter.
Fault. Is that what the
yeah,
quarter's
quarter,
for?
That's what the quarter's for.
Just, yeah, right.
Visual
aids. Yeah. I've got the visual aids.
And you got three treasures in case you need it, but you can only cast one spell, which you're
yeah.
already done, so.
Are you done it?
What are you doing with your life right now?
I am attacking you, Will, with
yeah, for
a
all that.
3-5 with flying and
lift
menace, and actually, I'm attacking you with a 2-4 with flying.
2-4 with flying.
Nothing I can do about that.
Nothing I can do about that.
And I'm gonna reveal the top card of my library. It's a Sarah Avatar. It costs 7, which is on.
And it deals that much damage to us?
No.
Does that
yeah, it would have been. It would have been.
It would have been
it
awful.
Been nice for the Twilight Prophet.
Yeah.
I would also gain that life, making it big enough. But, no, I just get to play it for free.
Oh, you just get to play it for free.
No
so
big
I
deal.
Have a 26.
Oh, my God.
Right.
Its power and toughness are each equal to my life total.
Is this a casting thing that you're doing?
Each equal to your life total.
Fuck, I can't cast it.
You
That's
can't.
Right. Otherwise...
Oh, you're exhausted.
Ah!
Oh, God. Really dodged a bullet there. See, after my episode, shit thing.
Stupid exhaustion. I'm too tired. That's such a bummer. God damn it.
I love okay. that.
Well,
Does that mean it just stays on top of your library?
No, it's otherwise draw a card. Okay. So, thanks for that.
Did Buckner untap during my turn?
Yes,
I forgot all about it.
Nope.
Oh,
because I did it during.
Oh,
your turn.
Oh yeah, he did it during your turn.
Oh, during my turn.
Yeah. That's a smart way to do it.
Fuck
Well, it's just your turn, Will, because I'm fucking tired.
Okay. I get to finally untap all my stuff. Stupid fucking echo guy. All you guys' stuff is black.
Disenchant that.
Should I just kill Ashley?
Disenchant it. You'll find a way.
Yeah,
keep praying.
Yeah.
Should I just kill Ashley?
Excuse you. Just kill Ashley.
That's who you're more worried about, huh?
Yeah, well, you can only play a spell a turn. That's kind of crippling
to
that deck.
Try and just kill me. That's what you wish.
I'm gonna try. I'm gonna
awesome.
Do 2 fours.
Why did I have to say that?
And 2 swamp.
Yeah.
To do Triumph for the Hordes.
Triumph of the Hordes.
Until end of turn, creatures I control get +1/+1 and trample and infect.
And
so I'm gonna attack you
trample.
With everything, actually.
And infect? Isn't it if it's 10 or more infect? Damage, I die?
Yeah. Isn't that like way more than 10?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sure seems like it.
Yeah, okay.
I'm just trying to make sure. Just doing. There's no question about it.
So, what? How much do you have?
He's hitting me with just all the
infect. 4/3/3 squirrels, so that's 12 right there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and she can block one of them.
No, the,
right.
the problem is the infect. Like, I have 32 life, I have a
right.
5. Defense, but I
you're pretty close to actually being able to kill both of us, it seems like.
Yeah, but you got blockers too. I
have 2 blockers.
No, he just wants to overkill me instead. Well, that's cool, Willis. Cool
yeah.
beans,
sorry, that's another.
I'm actually just attacking you with the 4 squirrels.
What?
And the 3/4.
Did Ryder just chalk you out of
that's
overkilling
okay.
me?
Well, yeah, I want some blockers in case Ryder wants to attack me.
Okay.
Oh, I thought the other ones were going to come at me.
Not, he is talking you into also hitting him now. Okay.
That's how we end the...
Wow, Ryder's
right.
skills
Wait, but you're still
of persuasion.
You're still attacking with, your head just going after Ashley for 16?
Yes, just
infect.
To make sure. Just to make sure. Just to make sure.
So I block one.
Okay.
Of the 2/2s, these are 3/1/1s, and
well,
this is
the 4/2/1, the 4/4. These are 3/3s.
This is the 4/5.
If I block the
4/3/3s.
4 or 3?
4/5.
4. If I block the 4, you know, I still have 8, 9, 10, 11 of it.
Uh huh.
So that's all you need.
Okay.
And you really shouldn't. Wait. This is a little.
Are you gonna cast
what's
something
up,
to change the outcome right now, or not?
Maybe, but I also did kind of like, you know, tell Will not to like attack you with like fucking everything.
And because you destroyed this one, each player may put any amount of mana to may pay any amount of mana to put
I'll try
that
and kill
number
him quickly, actually.
Of squirrel tokens into
I would
play.
Like to play.
Under his or her control. Treat those tokens as 1/1 green squirrel creature tokens. So I'm gonna pay.
So I was holding on to my foreboding fruit because so I should have just done it to you. I didn't want to anger you, like the wrath of the gods that you throw back at people like vindictively as you do. But right, this is cool in Sheoldred because target player loses 2 cards and loses 2 life. Or draws 2 cards and loses 2 life, so I can either lose or gain 2 life instead of 4 and not lose. Or I could cause, like, you to lose 6 life. Just bada bing, bada boom.
Pretty cool.
And I was going to make a food token because, yes, that all the black was going to be spent to cast it because it's mono mana a black. Anyway, I don't know why I'm rambling at this point. Guess I'm a little upset to be dead.
Okay, I'm going to pay 4 using 2 of my treasure.
I'm going to be a poltergeist when I grow up.
And I am not going to pay the corona, so you get corona on your turn?
Yeah. One of these squirrels. Okay, I think I'm gonna kill him pretty quickly. I don't know why you went after her and rather than me. She didn't have anything going on over there. We're really just...
Because we play more often. Traumatized by Sheoldred. He's being nice to you.
It's just that in your home. She just makes people upset.
We are at your home. Didn't want to shoot the host in the foot.
Like, barely.
Should've just called her candy.
Let's see here.
Right. With everything my words. Okay, so I'm gonna do my upkeep stuff correctly. So,
What are these?
Those are my 4 squirrels.
Why'd you get 4 squirrels?
That's not what that does. Not each one.
Did you pay mana?
I paid 4 mana.
Okay, good. Alright,
yeah, there's 2
all
treasure,
cool.
My 2
mana. Alright, cool.
Okay, so I guess I'm gonna stack it so the Twilight Prophet goes off first. Reveal the top card of your library and put it into your hand. Each opponent loses X life and you gain X life. That's its cost. It's 5. So, 32.
Begins.
Then I will scry from my eyes. And I'll go ahead and put that on the bottom. And then the debtor's knell. Oh, I guess I'll get your squirrel maker. And I have Corona. So, yeah, I'm gonna go to combat here.
You cast any spells yet?
Nope, I haven't cast any spells yet. I'll use my crystal ball. Do some scrying.
It's pretty clever.
That's what I'm trying to do, manipulate the top of my deck. Right, this one has some sweet news. Nothing to see
nothing
over there.
Nothing to see over there.
Alright, so when Corona attacks, each creature of the type of my choice gains +3/+3 until end of turn. I'm gonna choose squirrels.
Now why wouldn't you?
And I'm going to attack you with 4/4 squirrels.
Oh man.
And a 9/9 squirrel. And 2/4 with flying and a 3/5 with flying and hey, so let's see what happens. It's odd. I'd just rather cast something else. So I'm just gonna put it into my hand. Okay, just scribe it to the bottom.
Should have tagged you with everything.
Jesus.
Oh man.
Yeah, so like there's 5 in the air. Plus, 9/5, then.
Right, I'm gonna block
4/4 squirrels.
The 9 with one of the dryads, and then 4/4 squirrels.
So yeah, you get +3/+3.
Oh, goodness. And then I gotta take the 5 in the air total.
Yeah.
Okay, and then I'm gonna block
all four of the squirrels.
Let me see. Okay, right, you got five blockers.
Yeah.
You're still gonna take five from Corona?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Ouch. Ouch. Definitely should have gone after you. Regrets. Regrets.
Regrets.
Regrets.
Oh. Tale as old as time. Do you regret killing me?
I should have killed Ryder.
Probably. Okay, right. I should cast
good.
Something.
Like a good, what do they call those girls down under? Like a good sport.
Good sport? Right.
Yeah.
I don't get the analogy.
It's not an analogy. It's what they call sluts down under. Good sport.
I'm gonna play.
Just throwing all of Australia under the bus.
To ferry the time.
No slut shaming in this house.
No slut shaming, but you're not in the house.
It's true. You're also not down at that.
Right, and I am going to, do...
That's the one spell you choose to do, it's a printed spell you choose.
I'm going
to
do his minus.
What does his minus do, right?
Turn up to one target artifact, creature, or enchantment to its owner's hand. I don't know if you can bounce Corona's stuff, she doesn't have a hand.
Right.
But yeah, I'm just gonna no, that doesn't even make sense. I'm just gonna do this plus. I'm gonna do this plus. I can cast sorcery spells as soon as I have flash and turn to my next turn.
Okay.
And it's your turn.
Hey, Corona.
With one, two, three untapped. Is that right?
Yes, three untapped. Plus one treasure.
And treasure. I almost made a treasure. I remember long ago when I was playing.
Well, I can feel bad about it.
Oh, that's nothing. Yet.
Oh, no, that's not good either.
You should regret killing me so brutally. Ryder, avenge me.
I'm gonna tap four to do you met in tavern. And creatures I control are gonna get plus two to on the turn.
You know, you can always use a card from your hand to scoop from the side under a card you're trying to grab and having trouble with. Just saying.
Cloakwood Hermit enchantment background. Commander creatures I control would have, at the beginning of your end step, if a creature card would be put in the graveyard anywhere, that's trying to create two tap, 1/1 green squirrel creature tokens. I'm going to attack you with Corona and shoot squirrels.
What about a player put in the graveyard? I was murdered.
So, all my creatures have plus two, and all my squirrels have plus three, so almost worth it, plus five, plus five.
Son of a biscuit maker.
So there's six sixes, there's four of them, and there's Corona, five, five, and six.
Four six sixes, and Corona, the five, five, huh?
Yep.
Wow.
Okay. So I guess I will block one of the six sixes, and right, then I would just have to take 23.
Oh!
Okay, go 99.
Oh, I died.
You got any mana for squirrels, Will?
No, I do not. Do you?
I'm gonna spend four mana more squirrels.
Shit. Should've killed Ryder. Should've killed Ryder. I should've killed Ryder.
Okay.
Oh, whoops, not me.
Squirrels. There's my Corona. This guy needs... okay, so I'm gonna do my upkeep triggers. Bring this guy back.
Just taking my shit.
I'm going to scry.
No, we know. It is your shit.
It is my shit.
And then I'm going to do the Twilight Prophet. It's just a land. No life left.
That could have killed me right there. Maybe. No, not really. I don't think anything costs 15.
He's untapping lands.
Okay, so... Right. Am I trying to do anything here?
He's making choices.
That's cool, right? Second to the top.
Ooh, that's it.
Oh, I can't look. I can't see.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to do my crystal ball.
Ooh, look at that crystal ball. See what you see.
What does the future hold? Nothing exciting.
I know what he chose.
Then I'm going to attack
you. That just came back in.
Yeah, sorry, not that one. I'm gonna attack you with everything.
Are you gonna choose squirrels?
I am gonna choose squirrels. So you got 8/4/4 squirrels coming at you.
Jesus!
Oh!
Jesus!
Looks like a comeback!
Next thing, it's a Gilded Lotus. It costs 5.
It's a Gilded Lotus.
Cast that. Yeah, so. There's a 10. A 13-13, because it's also a squirrel. So 13-13, I assume you're going to want to block that one.
Yeah.
And then there's another 5, 10, plus 32. 8 times 4, it's 32.
32, yep.
Yes, that's 42 damage that I think is getting through.
Well, I'm going to block the 13-13 at least. And then, yes, I'm going to die.
Bravo. Squirrel got killed by squirrels.
Well.
The odds going on, even though Corona tried to hold it back, could not be held back.
The curse of exhaustion. Shit, I should have let another one of those squirrels get through. Could have had an extra turn. Somehow you would have had something up your sleeve to survive. Right. Second chance to.
Wow.
Your cards definitely let me win between your squirrel mob and that squirrel maker thing.
He shouldn't have murdered me.
Nope.
Yeah, shouldn't have murdered me when you
I should have gotten after you instead of her.